Hi guys, welcome to my first vlog. As you can tell from the title, I am going to be taking you on a week of my beauty treatments. So the first appointment you'll be coming to with me is my nails. I've got nothing on them at the moment. Usually I have SNS or gel. I feel like I go through phases of what I like. I was on Pinterest looking at different designs and then I was like, am I going to get sick of them after a while? Do I not do nail art? As you can see, my regrowth is crazy. This is my natural hair color and I dyed it a bit lighter, a bit blonder in February for my birthday, and I haven't dyed it since, so I'm in need of getting my hair done. So I'm also going to be taking you to the hairdressers. I think I want to go like a light brown all over. I'm also getting a lash lift, which I've had before. I was tossing up between a lash lift and lash extensions. I've decided to go for lash lift because my skin has broken out recently with eczema and some pimples. And you know when you just want to like cleanse your face and like scrub it properly, and when you have lashes you cannot do that. Also, these slugs that are living on my forehead rent free need grooming ASAP. They will start to blend into my hairline. I'm also going to be taking you to my laser appointment. I've got some discount codes for those too.
How good is it when you're in a rush to get to an appointment and there's traffic? Fantastic. What time is it? Ooh, I have 15 minutes to get there. You know, like on the maps when it goes like red? Yeah, there's like that much red on my maps, which is just awesome. Fantastic. We're on the freeway and it's, what am I going? 15 Ks. I'm going 15 Ks on the freeway with bumper to bumper. Fantastic. Fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. Anyway, we've got some time to chat, so let's chat. I'm going through like this stage of, am I too old for certain things? So like for instance, nail art. I went through like a phase where I was getting like gems, like really long nails and like colors and shit. And I don't know, when Ben proposed to me, it like changed. I don't know, it did something in my mind. Like, oh, I'm an adult now. Like, I'm adult. Like, well, I can't be walking around with hot pink nails and gems and this and that. Then I'm also like in this mindset of like, I'm 25. I'm literally the youngest I'm ever gonna be. Hopefully, fingers crossed, in the next few years, I'll have a baby. Like, my life will start to change and then I will be like proper adult. But I can worry about the short nails then, and I can like enjoy the long nail art with the gems and everything now. For me, 25 is a really weird age. It's like, am I young or am I old? Like in mid-20s, mid-20s, that's disgusting. Mid-20s, I don't wanna be mid-20s. I wanna be early 20s. I wanna be like young and fresh and, but then I also don't. Like, we've just bought our house. Like, this is the funnest thing ever. Like, we're planning our wedding. Again, I don't know if anybody else is like this, but like, I don't feel like an adult. Like, I still feel young, but then like, I've got adult responsibilities and I've got adult money and I've got like adult things in my life, like pap smears and shit. So I don't know. Am I young? Am I old? Am I in my peak? Am I youthful? I don't know anymore. But 25 is a weird age. So if you're younger than me, enjoy it. And if you're older than me, give me advice. Okay, so I've made it through the traffic, but I do not know where I am. Where has my maps taken me? I hate when this happens.
This is where I'm going today. It's called manicure laundry.
So wrapped, they have come out so good. Sort of, look at me shaking, far out. Oh my goodness, she put this like clear buildable like 3D-ish gel on them and then got and then she used, oh my god, my stomach's grumbling. I'm starving. It's hot today. I need to put the aircon on. And then she got like this gold powder and like rubbed it on. And it came out so cool.
Okay, so I've just gotten to my laser clinic. She's just moved into a new space. How beautiful is it? Like, look at this hallway and look at the furniture. Before Natalie moved into this new space, she actually is one of my clients and I designed her rebrand of her logo. So this is the logo that I designed for her, which is so cool to like see it in person. She's still rolling it out throughout the space. So So on Saturdays, they have a skin therapist that comes in and does all sorts of skin treatments in here. And then across here is the teeth whitening room. So there's another therapist that comes in, and on Wednesdays she does injectables. And then in here, she has a sauna that you can book out this whole room, listen to a podcast, read a book, and she's got a TV. You can watch some Netflix as well. And this is the laser room, and this is Natalie, the owner and founder. This is where I get all my treatments. This is her cool new machine that we use. And I'm just gonna get undressed and get ready. So I've done laser before at other places, and it was so painful and it was actually ineffective. I'd done about like 10 sessions, and then the girl that was doing it for me asked me if I was on birth control, which was so weird. I had no idea that it even impacted laser treatment. And yeah, so it never worked. So I'm so glad that I found Nat here at Laser Studio, because this treatment, I've been doing it for about 6 months, you reckon?
Yeah.
About 6 months, and I like don't have any hair anymore. Like my hair barely grows back. So this machine here is like incredible.
Basically, the machine that we use is the Alma Soprano Ice Platinum. So basically, it does 40% damage each session. Every other machine out there does roughly 10%, averages between 7 to 13%. So basically, you're getting 4 sessions in one being here. The bonus is that you can be fake tanned, you can have blonde hair, red hair, it can be any skin tone, it still is safe to treat. There's also that benefit of it actually feels like a massage. So you'll be getting treated, it won't be painful.
It doesn't feel like anything. Yeah. Like, I have zero pain tolerance.
Yes.
And me and Nat just sit here and we like chat shit the whole time. Because I don't feel a thing.
Yeah. So the way that it delivers the heat to you is a lot safer for your skin. So rather than putting an immense amount of heat with each individual pulse and making your skin go red, irritated, the way that it delivers you the heat is actually a lot safer, more comfortable for your skin. So it slowly warms up your skin to the temperature in order to destroy follicles. But for you, it just feels like a nice warm hot rock. So we're applying a gel, just here to mush the gel around. So basically it's -3 degrees.
Which it's actually freezing.
Yeah. So what's touching you is -3 degrees. What this does is it numbs the skin. So when we give you the heat, you don't really feel it as much at all. But I'll bring in, start lasering. That's all okay.
Like, yeah? I literally cannot feel a thing. Like, guys, I can't even go and get a blood test because I'm like faint. Like, so many people ask, like, would you get like Botox, would you get lip filler? Like, maybe, but like, I cannot do the needling.
Yeah.
I have zero pain tolerance. Yeah, so the fact that I can sit here and just like have a like casual chat, I cannot feel a thing.
I know, it's amazing.
And I also have a discount code for you guys. I'm gonna put it on the screen here, but it is just 10 for your first treatment, and that will be giving you 10% off.
Done.
So it's been a few days since I was last on here, but I'm currently at my lash and eyebrow specialist, Ruby Katz. This is her home studio. She's going to be cleaning up my eyebrows for me and doing a lash lift, which I'm in serious need of.
So this is the space. It is so nice. Look at it.
So Ruby's just mapping out my brows. So as you can see, they are so bushy. But she's mapping out what hair she's going to be taking away and what she's leaving. And then I think we're going to be filling them in with henna today. So the reason we've chosen to do henna today is because it will last longer than the tint, and it'll give a little bit more of that natural finish. So it almost looks like a powdered finish. And we're going to ombre the color out. So the ends are darker and the front is lighter. Morning. This is how my eyebrows and lashes have turned out. We left them a little bit bushy because I like to gel them up, so I've just put a bit of this through them this morning. I haven't got very long lashes, which is why I was even thinking of doing lash extensions in the first place, but I'm so happy with the way that they've like held the curl. They look so cute. But look how cute they look. Hey guys, I'm not very good at signing off from the other clips, but from the last thing that you've seen, I was talking about my lash lift and my eyebrows. Right now I'm at the salon. I'm at Salon Gabrielle and I'm with Claire and Liv. They're over here. They've come in on their day off to dye my hair and we're just deciding what we're gonna do with it. I really wanna go like a lighter brown like all over. So I think what we're meant to be doing is a three-quarter balayage. The girls know all the tones and everything. I've got no idea about that, but it's going to be a bit lighter than what it is. It's not going to be blonde per se, but a really like soft light brown. I was going to go foils to the root, but Claire was explaining to me that it's just way too much maintenance. Like I'll be back here every like 6 weeks. So we're going to do like a high balayage so that my roots will like blend out like a little bit more seamlessly, but going like lighter with my hair overall. I still have another just under 2 years until the wedding, so between now and then the girls were like, I can change my mind and do something different if I don't enjoy the color that I am going today, but I think I'm really gonna like it.
So this is the salon. I'm just gonna show you around. This is actually one of my clients as well. So I run the social media and do all the content creating for the salon and for Gabrielle Recruzzo. This is Liv and this is Claire. How nice it is.
Do the root stretch, which is blending in my regrowth to the foils so that it's more of a seamless grow out. Oh my god, look how bright it is.
I need a brush.
I'm so excited. And then we're gonna do a toner. And this is Liv.
Hi.
Liv's got her foils
on. I actually have my hair
done. Hair's done now.
Now I'll happily be in the video.
So the root stretch is just
developing.
The root stretch is developing right now. We're gonna leave it for a few more minutes. I have to turn the wrong way. And then
why are you looking like that?
I'm coming up to the root stretch to see it. I'm so excited. It looks so good. And yeah, I'd rather be lighter and then we can tone it down than go dark straight away.
Yeah. I think if you go dark, you're gonna feel too similar to what you were.
How do you mean?
Like, I think if we go dark, you're just gonna feel like it's just like higher, but it's like the same like brightness.
Yeah.
Because I feel like you were bright when you walked in. You just like,
yeah, but you had a big regrowth. It looks darker because of my regrowth.
Yeah.
How long does this stay in for now?
We'll check it after 10.
All right, so my hair is washed. Once we dry it, we're actually gonna see how the colors turned out. So I think I'm gonna do a big like bouncy blow wave. I think we're gonna do a bit of a trim first as well.
Yeah.
A trim, and then I'm gonna cut shorter face framing layers as well. Sorry, I keep looking in the viewfinder because I'm looking at my hair. So Claire was saying that this is a Jasmine Aiello special.
Literally.
Oh my god. It looks so amazing. I feel brand new. I'm actually just gonna like
just keep staring.
You're gonna come in with your hair, it's so oily because you're gonna keep touching it.
I know. It looks so good.
The bouncy is just
a lot.
She didn't want to go too long.
No, that's not.
She didn't even know what she wanted.
I love it.
It's so nice.
I love it.
It feels so nice and fresh. And like, she's not easy to
love. It's right down here.
Yeah. So.
Guys, I am so happy with it. Look how nice it is. I feel so fresh. And this is going to blend out so nicely. I am so sorry. I really need to get better at signing off on these videos. But thank you for watching my first vlog. I know it was choppy, but I really appreciate everybody who has made it this far and watched the whole video. Soon I will be giving an update on all things Tori and mine with Victoria. We've actually started making that vlog. That might take a few weeks, so in between then there might be some other content. But thank you for getting this far and for watching my videos. I really appreciate it.